Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about rational expressions, and this is the very first video, so we're just introducing the idea and talking about when is an expression undefined. So rational expressions are just fractions that contain variables or polynomials, either in the numerator or the denominator or both. And then we ask ourselves, when is an expression undefined? And so here's some examples of, here's four different rational expressions. This one just has a variable in the denominator and the numerator. This one has one in a binomial, polynomial, in the denominator. This one is something that needs to be factored, and so is this one, to be able to answer our question. In order to answer the question, when is this undefined, we have to remember that a denominator can never be zero when we're working with fractions. So that's the problem. If the denominator equals zero, we say that it's undefined. What values would cause these to be undefined? Well, to answer that, we simply set the denominator equal to 0 and solve. So for the first one, 3a over b, we set b equal to 0. And we would say, oh, wait, we're done, because we can't let b be 0. Because the 0 down there would cause that to be an undefined expression. 3a over 0 is undefined. Since if b was equal to 0, the expression would be undefined. We say that 0 is a restriction for this particular expression. So sometimes they say, when is this undefined? Or sometimes they'll say, list the restrictions. It's the same question. In the second one, we're going to do the same thing. We're going to set this equal to 0, but our denominator was x minus 1/2. If I set x minus 1/2 equal to 0, I get x equals 1/2 when I solve that. The 1/2, you can see if I plugged it in here, 1/2 minus 1/2 would cause that to be 0. If x equals 1/2, the expression would be undefined. So we say that 1/2 is a restriction, or x cannot equal 1/2. It can equal anything in the universe except for 1/2. So that's just how we would say that. For the last two, I'm not going to say that again, but we have this one, y squared minus 36, set it equal to 0. We're going to factor that, which is a difference of squares, y plus 6, y minus 6, and then set each of those factors equal to 0 and solve. If I move the 6 to the right, I would get negative 6, so that's one of our restrictions. And if I move this one over, I would get positive 6, so that's another restriction. So we have two restrictions here. This expression is undefined at 6 and negative 6. This one, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to set my expression on the denominator equal to 0. And p squared minus 2p minus 15 factors. I'm not showing you how to factor in this video, but there are other videos that you can go back and remind yourself how to do that. If I factor this, I get p minus 5 and p plus 3, and then I'm going to set each one of those factors equal to 0 and solve. And that gives me, when I move the negative 5 over, I get positive 5, and when I move the positive 3 over, I get negative 3, and that gives me my restrictions of 5 and negative 3. This expression is undefined at 5 and negative 3. And notice that in all the examples, we do not care about the numerator. We don't set the numerator equal to anything because we don't care if we have a 0 in the numerator. We only care about zeros in the denominator. All right, the next video will be simplify a rational expression. Have a great day.